Okay, so we're picking it up at Ephesians chapter 4. And he has talked about that he's a prisoner of the Lord, for the Lord. He's talked about some of the expectations, what it means to live the Jesus life. And as we get into verse 14, let's go 14 through 16. He says, "Then we will no longer be infants tossed back and forth by the waves and blown here and there by every wind of teaching and by the cunning and craftiness of people in their deceitful scheming. Instead, speaking the truth in love, we will grow to become in every respect the mature body of him who is the head, that is Christ. From him, the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love as each part does its work." So he's been talking about spiritual growth and how God gave the church gifts to help the church grow. And he says another goal of the congregation becoming spiritually mature here is that their maturity will protect them from false teaching. That's this whole idea. They won't be blown here and there by every wind of teaching and the cunning and craftiness of people and the deceitful scheming. Immature believers are like those who build their houses on sand. Storms can knock them over. Right? Hard things happen in life, and immature believers are all shaken by it. They're taken in by spiritual fads or charisma, or they're led by their emotions over truth. And they're susceptible to the clever schemes of false teachers. But when the congregation is mature, they are able to respond to false teaching with truth and love. And Paul says that we speak the truth in love because we don't want to use the same tactics as the enemy. Now, verse 16 says, "From him the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love as each part does its work." That says that when the church is healthy, and we talked about this last time, that means with the people of the church being prepared and equipped and trusted to do the work of the ministry. Remember, that's what he said in the previous verses. Okay, he gave pastors and teachers, apostles, prophets, and evangelists to equip his people for works of service so that the body of Christ may be built up. A healthy church is a church where the spiritual leaders are equipping the people to do the work of the ministry. Remember we talked about that last time? A healthy church is not where the pastor and the elders are making all the hospital calls. A healthy church is not where the pastor and the elders are doing all the teaching or heading up all the ministries. It's where they're working themselves out of those things because they're equipping the people to do them. That's a healthy church. So it's, he says here in verse 16 that when the church is healthy, with people being prepared and equipped and trusted to do the work of the ministry, that the phrase there, joined together and held together, means that the church is organized when it's healthy and everybody's serving. The church is then organized so that we depend on each other. We depend on each other. So kind of think of some kind of weaving, you know, where everything is kind of braided together. That's how it should be in the church, where we all are depending on each other and helping each other and strengthening each other. That's how the church should function. It results, he says here, in the church continually being knitted together. And what a beautiful thing when that happens. Now, remember that we talked about when we studied 1 Corinthians, a healthy church is going to have unbelievers attending it. A healthy church is going to have infants in Christ as part of the church. A healthy church is going to have people who are struggling in it. And a healthy church is going to have people who are mature. So what Paul describes this, he says, don't just think you can do this when the church reaches perfection, because the church never reaches perfection, right? We have people in process. We better. If you have a church that's just people who are all mature in the faith, well, I wouldn't even call them that. Okay, if they're not bringing people in, they're not mature in the faith. They might be old in the faith, but they're not mature in the faith, right? Because one of the signs of maturity is you're going to be evangelistic. You're going to be rubbing shoulders with people who need Jesus. You're going to be impacting the people around you. So you might be old in Christ, but you're not mature in Christ. So he says here, we need to do that, and we need to continue doing that, growing the church together, equipping one another, strengthening each other.